वेलकम टू इंट्रोडक्शन टू एंटोमोलॉजी अंडर द कोर्स फंडामेंटल ऑफ एंटोमोलॉजी फॉर यूजी क्लासेस पर्टिकुलरली। आई एम डॉक्टर रविंद्र प्रसाद, सीनियर साइंटिस्ट एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर। आई एम हियर टू डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन फंडामेंटल ऑफ एंटोमोलॉजी, सम फंडामेंटल एस्पेक्ट। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज एंटोमोलॉजी? Before going to the term entomology, we should learn what is biology. Biology means science of biological organism, science of life. And biology can be broadly divided into two parts, zoology and botany. Zoology is the science of animal fauna, whereas botany is a science of plants. Then entomology is a branch of biology under this subject zoology that deals with this studies of insect, and it aims at understanding all aspects of insect in their life. Entomology is a Greek word. That means entomon means insect and logos means discourse or study. So according to Greek origin, in Greek word, entomon means insect and logos means discourse or study, that is a study of insects. Then the origin is derived from Latin word of entomology, that means something cut into. That is, the body and appendages of insect, like in other arthropod, are divided into several segments. Insects belong to the subclass, superclass Hexapoda, under the phylum Arthropoda. And Hexapoda comprises of six legs arthropods, which include true insects. However, in practice, all Hexapodan arthropods are collectively called insect. Hexa means six, poda means legs. That means six-legged organism simply can be termed as insects. Six legs, that is three pairs of leg. Organism having three pairs of leg can be said to insect. Now entomology can be divided into two parts, fundamental entomology or general entomology, and second one is applied entomology or economic entomology. Under fundamental entomology deals with the basic or academic aspect of science of entomology, and fundamental entomology includes morphology, anatomy, physiology, taxonomy of insect, different aspect of insects. In this case, that is in case of fundamental entomology or general entomology, in this case we study the subject for gaining knowledge on entomology irrespective of whether it is useful or harmful. That means we will study under general entomology all insect encompassing useful insect or harmful insect. Then applied entomology or economic entomology deals with the usefulness of the science of entomology for the benefit of mankind. That is applied science of, it deals with, applied entomology covers the study of insects which are either beneficial or harmful to mankind. It deals with the ways in which beneficial insects like predators, parasites, pollinators, productive insects like honeybee, silkworm and like insect can be exploited for our welfare. Applied entomology also studies methods in which harmful insect or pest can be managed without causing significant damage to our crore. So, next aspect is history of entomology, development of science of entomology in India. What is the background of entomological science in the country? What is the background of development of entomological science in the country or Indian subcontinent? During 1758, 8th edition of Systema Naturae by Carl Linnaeus, having 28 species, was mentioned. Then Jesus Fabricius, the first entomologist who made any extensive study of Indian insects, and the person is Jesus Fabricius, who classified the insect into 13 orders based on types of mouth parts. Jesus Fabricius classified different insects into 13 orders based on their type of mouth parts. During 1767 and 1779, J.G. Koenig, in 18th century, collected number of insects from Coromandel area and southern peninsular region of India. Then 1785, Asiatic Society of Bengal started in Calcutta. Further, 1791, Dr. J. Anderson issued a monograph on cochineal scale insect. This is first monograph on cochineal scale insect written by Dr. J. Anderson in the year 1791. Then 1893, Rothney published on Indian arts, earliest record of biological pest control in our country, white ants attacked on stationary items was kept free by red ants. This is first example of biological control in our country, which was made by Rothney in 1893, wherein white ant, which was found attacking on accessory items, that was controlled or managed by red ants. Then 1901, Lionel Nisvelli, first entomologist to the Government of India. Lionel D. Nisvelli was appointed the first entomologist of Government of India during 1901, and 2 years after, that is during 1903, Professor Maxwell Lefroy succeeded Nisvelli as Government entomologist. That means Professor Maxwell Lefroy was second entomologist of Government of India, and he was appointed as government entomologist in 1903. 2 years after, in 1905, establishment of IARI at Pusa, Bihar happened. And Professor Lefroy became the first imperial entomologist. Then 1906, Indian Insect Pest is a book which was written by Professor Lefroy. This is first book which was written on the Indian insect pest, having various insects. And the author was Professor Lefroy, who was first imperial entomologist appointed in 1905. Then 1906, Indian Insect Pest was also written by Professor Lefroy. And in 1909, Indian Insect Life was written by Professor Lefroy. That means within 3 years duration, he wrote, Professor Lefroy has written 2 books. That is, first one is Indian Insect Life, second one is Indian Insect Life. In 1912, Plant Quarantine Act was enforced in the country. In 1912, Plant Quarantine Act was enforced in India. And 2 years later, 1914, Destructive Insect and Pest Act, in short it is called DIPA, that is Destructive Insect and Pest Act, was passed in 1914. In the same year, T. Fletcher, the first government entomologist of Madras state, published his book Some South Indian Insects. T. Fletcher was appointed as entomologist government of Madras state, and he has written a book named Some South Indian Insects. In the same year, that is 1914, E.P. Stebbing written a book, Indian Forest Insect of Economic Importance, with reference to Coleoptera. And two years later, that is 1916, Imperial Forest Research Institute, IFRI, was established at Dehradun, which is now, it is known as IFRI, Indian Forest Research Institute, but when it was established in 1916, it was called as Imperial Forest Research Institute and located at Dehradun. In 1916, Natural History Section of Indian Museum was formed as Geological Survey of India. This was landmark for entomological studies when Natural History Section of Indian Museum was formed as Geological Survey of India. In 1921, Indian Central Cotton Committee was formed to investigate pest on cotton. So crop wise, this is the first step taken by our authority in the country during British period, and Indian Central Cotton Committee was constituted in order to investigate pest of cotton, because cotton is a crop which is heavily damaged by insect pest. And in 1925, Indian Lake Research Institute was started in Ranchi, erstwhile Bihar, now Indian Lake Research Institute, which was started in 1925, renamed as, research name is National Institute of Natural Resins and Gums, and this institute is Apex Institute. On earlier it was institute for only lake research, which was known as Global Apex Institute on Lake Research, and now it is National Level Institute on National Institute on Natural Gums and Resins. In 1934, Hem Singh Pruthi, who succeeded Fletcher as Imperial Entomologist, made efforts to bring all entomological workers much closer, which resulted into Foundation Entomological Society of India. This is very glorious year for science of entomology, when Hem Singh Pruthi established, founded a society on entomology, and the society was named as Entomological Society of India in 1938. And Afzal Hussain was appointed as President, first President of Hindu Society of India, and Vice President was himself, Hem Singh Pruthi, and Ramakrishna Iyer. Two Vice President, the first Vice President is Hem Singh Pruthi, second one is Ramakrishna Iyer, and headed by as President Afzal Hussain of the Indology Society of India. The official publication of society is the Indian Journal of Indology. This is very prestigious journal of Indology in the country. It is still continues, having four issues in a year. In 1939, Locust Warning Organization was established. In 1939, Locust warning organization was established, because locust was a very destructive pest, having sudden outbreak as a swarm. This within 2-3 years also, recent years also, locust is making very severe support agriculture and crop production. This year also, certain states are facing locust problem, and in this context I want to mention 1939 Locust Warning Organization was first established. In 1940, Dr. T.B. Ramakrishna Iyer published the book entitled Handbook of Hindu Economic Indology for South India, and the author was Dr. T.B. Ramakrishna Iyer. And the Vice second edition was published in 1963, after almost 23 years. In 1963, textbook of agriculture Indology was written by H.S. Pruthi. In 1968, Dr. M.S. Mani wrote a very good book on Indology entitled General Indology. And 1 year after, that is in 1969, Dr. Pradhan's Insect Pest of Crop was written. And in 1946, Directorate of Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage of Government of India started, just before independence. In 1960, the Desert Locust in India monograph was written by Y. R. Rao. And 1968, the Government of India enacted Central Insecticide Act, which came into force from 1st January 1971. And this act is still going on to govern all aspects of insecticide and pesticides. In 1969, the monograph on Indian Thanatophora was published by Dr. T.N. Anandakrishnan. Dr. T.N. Anandakrishnan, he was a native of Tamil Nadu, was a stalwart entomologist, and he worked a lot on the insect belonging to the order Thysonoptera, and the member insect is thrips. So this is all about history of Indology in India. Now I am coming on what are the factors which are responsible for dominance of insect on the globe. Among the animal fauna, animal kingdom organisms, 85% of the animal kingdom members are occupied by insects itself. So more number of species, that is in the animal kingdom, more than 85% of the species belong to insect group, and total number of insects described so far is more than 10 lakh and even more. Second point is large number of individual in single species. That is, locust swarm comprise of 10 to the power 9 number of individual occupying large area. Single type of insect that is locust swarm comprise of 10 to the power 9 number of individual occupying large area. And these are various type of insect belonging to the various orders. These are the photograph of various type of insect belonging to the various orders, genus and species. Third one is great variety of habitats. Insect have great variety of habitat. They are capable to live, they are capable to dwell in various type of ecologies. They can survive in various type of diverse type of ecological conditions. Insects thrive well under varied conditions. And fourth one is long geographical history, geological history. Insects were known to occupy this earth for more than 350 million years ago, which is a good track record. This has given the insect great variety of adaptation under different conditions. Then what are the reason behind the dominance of insect on the globe? Number one is capacity of flight. Insect possess wings, which is that lateral extension of exoskeleton of the insect. Insects are the earliest animal and only flying invertebrates. In the invertebrate group of animals, only insect have the capacity to fly. And flight is used for so many purposes, and those purposes may be to seek food, to mate, to shelter, to position sites, to colonize in the new habitat, and also to exchange habitat. If they are traveling the native habit, they can migrate into another habit through flight. To escape from enemies and unfavorable conditions, flight is also used to escape from enemies and unfavorable conditions. Flight also enable the insect to migrate, that is for long distances, that is locust may migrate from far away distances to the another new destiny or new places. Second one is adaptability or universality. Insects are the earliest group to make their life on the earth and to occupy vast habitat of soil and water. Insects are found in wide range of climatic conditions from minus 50 degrees centigrade to above 40 degrees centigrade. Scilopa petroli is an insect which can be found in crude petroleum well. Even petroleum well can be an ecology, is an ecology where some insects are found, and the insect is Scilopa petroli. If hydra fly living in great salt lake, salty condition also, salty water also, some insects are there. And the example is, if hydra fly, every flowering plant providing food for one or many photophagous insect. So many insects are found to feed upon different flora and plants, and that insect which can feed upon plants, they are known as phytophagous insect. And all sort of pest, crop pest, which belong to insect, they can be termed as phytophagous insect pest. Even the decomposing materials is also serving for food for many insect, and those insect which can feed on decomposing materials are termed as saprophagous insect. And some insect also feed upon other animals and insect as a parasite, and they are known as carnivorous insect. Third point of dominance is size of the insect. Majority of insects are small, conferring different physiological and ecological advantages. And this size of the insect also enable the insect to dominate in the ecosystem, and this help in exploitation of numerous ecological niches inaccessible for other animals. and lesser space, they require lesser space, less food, less time, energy requirements for development, their development and sustaining life. Energy utilization of insect is maximum. It has less gravitational effect. Muscular action and tracheal respiration make the insect more effective. It has very easy escape from enemies due to various reasons, including flight. Fourth one is exoskeleton. Insect body of the insect covered with an outer cuticle. That is called exoskeleton, which is made up of a cuticular protein called chitin. This is light in weight. Chitin is light in weight and gives strength, rigidity and flexibility to the insect body, which is a boon to the insect fauna in dominating over other fauna. Exoskeleton cross-section uses acts as external armor, provides space for muscle attachment, prevents water loss. Fifth one is resistance to desiccation. Insect minimize the water loss. Insect are capable to minimize the water loss from their body surface through prevention of water loss, wax layer, spiracles, conservation of water and rectal resorption. Sixth one is tracheal system of respiration. Unlike other organisms, insect ensures direct transfer of adequate oxygen to the actively breathing tissues, spiracles, through their closing mechanism, admit air and restrict water loss. Trachea are found spread over the body of the insect, which are used as respiratory organ, like other organisms. Seventh point or seventh feature for dominance of insect is reproductive potential. Reproductive potential of insect is very high due to so many reasons. And the reasons are egg laying capacity is very high. And egg laying capacity is technically known as fecundity of the insect. That is, queen termite can lay 6,000 to 7,000 eggs per day, even for longer period up to 15 years. Development period is very short. Corn aphid produces 16 nymphs per female, which reaches the adulthood within 16 days. Thereby, one generation is completed within a short period of 16 days, which favors greater genetic changes in the insect population, like quicker development of insect resistant strains. Due to short life cycle, so many generations are found of the same insect in a year or in a season. This is also a very good point, a very good capacity, which is responsible for dominance of insect. Full selection of egg laying sites and protection of eggs. Insects are very wise in selecting egg laying sites and their protection. Insects exhibit parental care like progressive provisioning, for example, bees, and mass provisioning, that is, wasp. Presence of special types of reproduction other than oviparity and viviparity. Polyembryony is also a good feature of which is found in insect. And in polyembryony, development of many individuals from a single egg can be happened. For example, parasitic wasp, in case of parasitic wasp, development of many individuals are taking place from a single egg. And in parthenogenesis, reproduction without male or without fertilization can take place. Pseudogenesis is also a phenomena type of reproduction, and this phenomena, reproduction by immature stages can take place. Immature stages also are capable to reproduce young ones. For example, certain flies. Eighth feature is complete metamorphosis. More than 82% of all insects undergo complete metamorphosis. And complete metamorphosis are known as holometabola. And the insect is known as holometabolous insect with four stages. In 82% in case of 82% of insect, complete metamorphosis is the phenomena through which insect develop from egg to adult stage. And in case of complete metamorphosis, that is holometabolous insect, the stages are egg, larva, pupa and adult. And egg is inactive, inexpensive, inconspicuous and embryo developed inside. And larva is active, feeds, digest, grows and store food. And pupa is inactive, where internal reorganization and resist adverse conditions, and it is known as resting phase of the insect, where inner development is going on and on. Adult is active, which are capable to reproduce and disperse. As the larval and adult food sources are different, competition for food is less. It is very interesting to mention here that larva is a second stage of the insect, which required another type of food, where an adult required another type of food. So there is no food competition between two stages of the same insect species. It's a very interesting feature which has gifted the nature to the insect. The photograph, egg, first one is egg, then larva, then pupa, and then adult. It is meaning thereby, adult female lays eggs. After hatching eggs, larva emerge, and after maturation of larva, next stage is coming, that is pupa. And then after maturation of pupa, adult emerges. Ninth one is defense mechanism. Peculiar defense mechanism is also found in insect. And by using this defense mechanism, insect escape from the enemies to increase their survival rate. In defense mechanism, behavioral mechanism is also there. Thanatosis is a process where insect pretends as if it is dead. Example is some beetles. Then we will going to touch the such beetles, they pretend just like as if they are dead, but they are not dead generally. And a structural defense mechanism is also there, in which hardened four wings of beetles are there. In case of beetles, four wings are very hard, and this hardness of four wing protect the beetle from the predation of birds. Because so many predatory birds are found in the ecosystem, they predate upon the insect, and in case of beetles, elytra is very hard, and on account of hardness of elytra, in so many cases, birds are unable to predate upon. Colorational mechanism. Presence of protective colors also make very competitive feature to the insect. Then chemical features also. Presence of defensive chemicals which bees producing venom. In case of honeybee, they are producing venom which can be make use for their protection. Tenth one is hexapod locomotion. In case of insect, uses though in insect six legs are there, but insect uses three legs at a time during locomotion, while the remaining three legs are static, which gives them greater stability and good locomotion. Then classification of animal kingdom. Next issue is classification of animal kingdom. Animal kingdom can be divided into invertebrate and vertebrate. In phylum, in invertebrate, so many phylum are there. That is, they are protozoa, porifera, platyhelminthes, nematelminthes, trochoelminthes, brachypoda, bryozoa, mollusca, echinodermata, annelida, onychophora, coleoptera, arthropoda. In case of vertebrate, they are chordata. Position of insect in the animal kingdom continued. This is also continued in classification of insect, taxonomy of insect. Animal kingdom, in case of invertebrate animals without back, invertebrate animal or those animal which lack backbones. And in invertebrate, so many phylum are there, but we are studying deeply phylum Arthropoda, and in Arthropoda we will study deeply Insecta, Hexapoda. So in Arthropoda, five important groups, that is Onychophora, Crustacea, Arachnida, Chelopoda, Diplopoda, Insecta are there. Onychophora example is Peripatus. Here is the photograph of Peripatus. Crustacea is another group in which crab and prawn belongs. In Myriapoda, millipede and centipede, in millipede and centipede belongs. Diplopod means millipede and chelopod means centipedes. And in Myriapoda, centipede is a creature which are found in moist and damp conditions. In particularly in rainy season, these are more prevalent in the ecosystem. It can be seen even in our house sometimes. Arachnida is another order. And important members are a scorpion, a spider, and mites. The creature belonging to Arachnida, the support belonging to Arachnida, usually bears four pairs of limbs. So they are known as octopod, since they are having four pair of legs, that is eight legs. Eight means octa. So they are known as octopod. But here we are not concerned with a scorpion. We will study only mites and a spider. Mites are the organism having four pairs of legs normally, with few exceptions. That is, European mite bears only two pairs of legs. It is a remarkable fact that in case of mite in adult stage, they bear four pairs of legs. But in case of larval stage, only three pairs of legs in case of mite are found. With few exceptions, that is, European mite bears only two pairs of legs. And another member of Arachnida is a spider, which also bears four pairs of legs, but they are not phytophagous in nature. They are treated as natural enemy of phytophagous insect. Salient features of arthropods. Insects are invertebrate groups in the phylum Arthropoda. Ortho means joint, poda means foot. And subphylum Uniramia, characters of the phylum Arthropoda are segmented body, segmented group into two or three regions, that is tegma, known as tegmosis, enable chitinous exoskeleton, and grow by molting. Molting processes is found in insect. Bilateral symmetry of the body is also characteristic feature of insect. And salient feature of arthropod, body cavity filled with blood, called homochoel. Body cavity of the insect is known as homochoel. Tubular alimentary canal with mouth parts and anus at anterior and posterior ends are found. And dorsal heart with valve-like ostia is found in case of insect. These creatures, dorsal brain with ventral nerve are also found. Striated muscles with dark and light bands, and no cilia, that is hair-like vibratile structure on the spacer on the cell is found. Paired and segmented appendages are also one of the feature. These are radial symmetry. Left side is radial symmetry, and right side, in case of beetle, it is bilateral symmetry. In case of majority of insect, bilateral symmetry of the body is found, and in some in few insect, radial symmetry is also found, which is shown in the photograph in right side, and left side bilateral symmetry example is there. This is all about the history of entomology, basic concept of entomology, dominant feature of the insect in the on the globe. This is last all about the lecture of today's delivery. Thank you.